Hi, today we will present you a macro-based approach to unfreeze all worksheets across all open workbooks. This is a follow-up to an earlier video on freezing panes across all worksheets and multiple workbooks. As most Excel users are aware, Excel will only permit us to unfreeze panes in one worksheet in one workbook simultaneously. It will not permit the selection of multiple worksheets over workbooks to unfreeze panes simultaneously. Therefore, we need to go to Visual Basic for Applications and Composer Macro. Next, insert a module. It is desirable to document your macro so that future macro users will be able to more effectively assess or edit the macro at a future date. We will call this macro Unfreeze Panes Sheets Workbooks. To begin with, it is preferable to disable these Excel properties before starting the macro. Next, we should declare key object variables for the macro. These object variables will be crucial in the proper execution of the macro across all worksheets and workbooks. As per the green font comments, it is time to state the location of certain object variables. Start workbook, start sheet, and start cell. We must now insert the first loop code into the macro. This part of the code will enable a macro to move across all the open workbooks. This second loop code will ensure the macro shifts across worksheets in an individual workbook. The macro will now be able to unfreeze the panes in the same locations for each worksheet in a specific workbook. This code will shift the cursor to the next worksheet in the particular workbook. Once the macro has cycled through all the worksheets in an individual open workbook, we need to return the cursor to the initial worksheet in this underlying workbook and cell address A1. The macro has finalized the freezing of panes across all sheets. This code will move the cursor to the next open workbook. Next, this piece of code will return the macro back to the original open workbook. We can now re-enable the following Excel properties. Let's review the code before we run the macro. Make sure to place the cursor in cell address B2 before we run the macro. Let's run the macro. As we can see, the macro is correctly unfreezing the panes in each worksheet across each open workbook as required. Feel free to comment to this video, like this video, or subscribe to our channel.